Alright, let's talk about art scams. I'm an artist myself, and I've been doing commissions for around a couple of years now. I've definitely seen my fair share of commission scams going around, and I don't think they're talked about enough. So first off, I want to say, if you are an artist that's doing commissions, you should always have clear terms. Because scams can be possible from both sides, and there can always be these trust issues between the client and the artist. Laying out your terms just ensures that you won't get scammed and your client knows what to expect. Now, when I'm taking payment for a commission, I usually give the client the option to either pay up front or pay after the sketch is done and they approve how it looks so far, and then we can go from there. This way the client knows I'm actually working on the piece and not running away with the money, but it also stops scammers from running away with the art without paying. I know some people also take half payment before and half after the artwork is done. That's another way you can approach it as well. But however you go about it, just make sure that you don't give someone like the full finished piece before they pay, unless you know for sure that it's someone you completely trust. Anyway, let's talk about some of these scams that I see. Now, this first one I've run into a couple of times and it seems to be getting a little more common. I call it the trust fund scam. How this usually goes is a scammer will contact you through like social media or wherever you post your art, and then they'll ask you for a commission. The interaction seems normal at first. I mean, you'll respond, they'll give you some details. It's always some overly detailed story for some reason. That's something to look out for. But yeah, when it comes down to payment, that's where it gets a little bit sus. They'll offer to pay through like their child's trust fund or savings account or something like that. I mean, straight away, that's just really odd, right? They tell you that they'll write you a check and you have to scan it through your mobile banking app or through your bank. And if you ask for any other form of payment like PayPal, they'll insist that they have no other way to pay. Like, yeah, makes sense. You're able to pay $200 for an artwork through your child's trust fund, but not able to pay through like card or PayPal or anything like that. I mean, I've never gotten past this step. I just block them as soon as they bring up the trust fund thing. But I'm guessing they have some sort of way to grab your info when you scan whatever they send you. I just know that it's obviously not legit and you should not trust that at all. Also, I don't know why, but in my experience, it's always been $200 they've offered to pay. Like, I don't know if that's just part of the copy-paste script or whatever, but yeah. So here's another scam I want to talk about, the classic suspicious file. This one starts pretty normal as well, just someone requesting a commission and then you're talking about details. I mean, you can see here in this conversation, I had no idea that anything was going on. I mean, it just seemed like a wholesome interaction of someone wanting gift art for their girlfriend, which is pretty common for commissioners. When I asked for reference images, that's where things got dodgy. So I got sent like a zip file with a bunch of images and then some weird file which I didn't recognize that seemed to be pretty badly disguised as an MP4 file. I mean, kind of pathetic, but sure. At this point, I kind of knew something was up, so I already knew I probably wasn't going to be working on this commission. I just played along with it and said, got them, I'll start working on them as soon as I can. Obviously, I didn't click this SCR file. I just pretended like I hadn't seen it or something. I don't know. So yeah, after I responded, they, of course, mentioned this video that they sent, telling me to click it like I'm an idiot. So I'm like, I don't know, seems a little bit sus. So I'm like, any chance you could send that video as an MP4 file? I don't tend to open files I don't recognize. Lol, I hope you understand. Still playing dumb, like I don't know what this fool's trying to do. So, you know, they tell me to open it anyway, because of course they want me to click this dodgy file. So I think, you know what, since it's a video, can't you just screenshot the part that you want me to see? Yeah, I never heard from them again. So after I actually did a little research on this, and from what I found, it's basically a piece of spyware, and if you click it, it will like hide in your computer and it can steal any sensitive data like passwords, personal info, stuff like that. I mean, general rule of the internet, if you're sent a file that you don't recognize, just don't click it. It's that easy. I mean, those are like the main scams I wanted to talk about because they're like the two I see the most. But in general, there are like red flags you should look out for when you're taking commissions, and you should know how to spot them. The first red flag is if it sounds too good to be true, like if someone's offering loads of money for something that usually wouldn't charge that much for. This alone isn't a huge red flag depending on the context, but it is a reason to be cautious. I mean, at the same time, you could just have a really generous customer, so get that bread. What is wrong with me? Another red flag to look out for is scammers tend to have some kind of story, but it always seems really impersonal. Kinda like they're just copy-pasting from a script, You can actually see that in one of the examples from earlier, like this story here. Actually, both of these examples have it. Like, you could see how these would be easy to just copy and paste to loads of artists. You should also look out for, like, strange forms of payment, adding on from that trust fund example again, but any weird kind of payment, just don't trust it. But yeah, in general, just use your common sense, you know, like, if they insist to pay only after you send the art, that's clearly sus. If anything seems off, just trust your gut and be careful, you know? Alright, that's pretty much it. I also take commissions, you know, if you like my art and don't want to get scammed, I don't scam people, I promise. You can check my Instagram for examples or like my commission page, and it helps me do cool things like eat and yeah. I mean, general rule of the internet. General rule. Why is that so hard to say? Okay, I mean, general rule.